and basically they're going to be doing this little motion here where they're trying to jump out of their harness a lot, if not reversing. So I'll get you to loosen the harness
so it's not very tight at all. So you can almost fit a finger under like that. You don't want it too loose so they can get out, but you want it loose enough that they're not going to be complaining that it's on. You don't actually need it to restrain them as much as backup.
I'm going to take you guys outside. Sorry for it being low lighting.
Notice how the string's walking behind them? That's what you want at all times. If he starts to walk the other direction, you follow him. You don't want them to feel like it's obligatory. Because things that will distract them are like bushes, trees, animals, people. He wants to go back over here, so I stop. What I don't do is drag them. Dragging them is counterproductive. Staying still is fine. My feet are planted. I'm just moving at a pivot. Logan. Then you walk towards him. Try to cut him off. See how he's following my feet there? By scraping my feet, it's a little game for him. Yeah. That was really high distraction, so I shouldn't have started there. So I'm doing a sound off call with my whistles. This is just to let them know where I am. Their vision's not that great. Because if I duck down, believe it or not, he loses sight of me. He needs to see this big black shape in front of him.
Me.
Come on, buddy. You notice how this leash is never tense? It's always just like a rope. And it's not heavy, so it's not dragging on him. So to him, it feels like he's off leash. This is a part of actually training him to go off leash. Like, I'd be fully willing to take his leash off right now. Because I know he's good at coming back, but there's a road right here, so that's why it's on. So you notice how there's a distraction there, such as the gate? What I want to do is back myself up about 2 feet away from that. See how he just sprints away from it, like nothing happened? Like, our objective is walking down this road. He's just walking a sideline. Oh, he's coming. He's coming. Yeah, ferrets can run. Distraction. So you stop when they stop. He might be going potty. His tail's slightly lifting up. What I do here is I get closer while I shorten the leash by wrapping it around, kind of like you would with a hobo rod fishing reel. And what they tend to do is just run along the side here. They're not really going to be jumping over, but I don't want them to because I'll get caught up in that fence. So if you guys haven't already, can you please hit that subscribe button and the bell? I've only got 2% of my viewers being subscribers. That means all you guys are new viewers. So thank you to all my new viewers. This is a highly requested video. I hope I did this enough self-explanatory. I'll go over it again. Basically, you have a loose harness so they don't feel like it's on. And then you don't really pull on the leash as much as stay as a barrier. Like, imagine you're a stake in the ground and you're just pivoting. That's how they will walk on a leash without them tantruming. A tantrum is like when you go like this, you start pulling the ferret. You notice how he's just like digging into the ground? That's not good. If you do that enough, you're gonna break your bond a bit. So it's better just to let him do his own thing. When you wanna get his attention, circle him until he follows you. Eventually he will just start chasing you. Like this. Notice how he's following me? That's just all you do. Grasslands is highly distracting. What you would prefer to do is get him onto the gravel road. I'll demonstrate. See how he looked at me when I whistled? Come on, buddy. Come on. I'm not pulling on the leash at all. I'm just whistling at him. So, I hope this demonstrates enough. They're not always perfect. They do stop like that, take a breather. But they're pretty good at walking. That occasionally happens where they bolt off to the side because they got distracted. Notice I'm not pulling. They do follow. Come here, buddy. He wants to go play in the grass. This way. There you go, good boy. Come on, Logan. Come on, buddy.